The Japanese debt watcher affirms its investor-grade credit rating for the Philippines. Ratings and investment information kept its BBB+ status for the Philippines, citing, among others, an improving fiscal position and a sound banking system. The BBB+ rating is 2 notches higher than the minimum investment grade. Finance Chief Benjamin Diokno welcoming RNI's improved outlook. He says this shows the country is on track to achieving its A rating from debt watchers. Diokno also says they're committed to further improving the Philippines' investment climate. The Marcos administration mobilizes an interagency committee as it aims to get an A credit rating before the president's term ends. Dubbed the Road to A program, the goal is for the committee to increase the Philippines' visibility to credit rating agencies. An A rating signals that the country offers a conducive environment to long-term investments, which could attract more foreign investors and generate jobs. It will also give access to loans with better interest rates. At present, Fitch has the Philippines at BBB rating, a notch below A. Moody's rates the Philippines at Baa2, 1 notch above the minimum investment grade and 2 notches away from A. Meanwhile, S&P Global also has the Philippines at BBB.
Tensions flaring once more between the Philippines and China. Beijing's envoy to Manila is summoned as government conveys a diplomatic protest over the Chinese Coast Guard's latest use of a water cannon against a Filipino vessel in the West Philippine Sea. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. spoke for the first time on the incident earlier today. He says Manila will continue to assert its rights in its waters.
Ang ating Secretary of Foreign Affairs ay pinuntahan si Ambassador Huang ngayong araw at nagdala ng isa pang note verbal kasama na ang mga picture, mga video kung ano mga pangyayari. At titignan natin kung ano yung kanilang magiging sagot. Ngunit sa atin ay actually today, pagkatapos ng change of command ng CGPA, ay magkakaroon kami ng command conference tungkol nga dito on how we will respond. We continue to assert our sovereignty. We continue to assert our territorial rights in the face of all of these challenges, and consistent with the international law.
The National Security Council now demanding a halt to what it called as China's coercive and unlawful activities in the West Philippine Sea.
This government will not lose any inch of our territory. We will never waver in our determination to resupply our troops stationed in Ayubid Shoal and in other Philippine-occupied features. Under the leadership of President Marcos, we will uphold the implementation of the 2016 Arbitral Award in relation to our rights in the West Philippine Sea in defense of a rules-based international order. Our position is clear. The award is final and indisputable, and we firmly reject attempts to undermine it. But guided by the President, we will always pursue constant dialogue and diplomatic approaches with other claimants.
Philippine Central Bank Governor Eli Remolona says government is monitoring potential risks to inflation, including El Nino and its impact on rice exporters like Vietnam, a major source of rice for the Philippines. Inflation, which eased to 4.7% in July, could see an uptick if the price of rice increases. Remolona urges government to implement non-monetary policy interventions such as timely importation, proper utilization of calamity and quick response funds, and expediting measures to mitigate the impact of El Nino. If done right, analysts believe these will ease the pressure for the BSP to hike rates again. The Philippines saw one of the most aggressive tightening, with the BSP raising rates by 425 basis points since 2022 to 6.25%. Here at home, pump prices set to go up for a fifth straight week. Diesel prices will see the biggest jump of 4 pesos per liter, while kerosene prices will increase by 2 pesos and 75 centavos per liter. Gasoline prices will also rise by 50 centavos per liter. The Energy Department cites production cuts of Saudi Arabia and Russia for the latest price hike.
Ito po yung tuloy-tuloy na effect nung ginagawang production cut ng Saudi Arabia. Ngayon po, nag-implement po ngayong August ang Saudi Arabia. Sinasabayan po ito ngayon, katatapos pa lang ng ministerial meeting ng OPEC Plus nitong August 3. Dumagdag pa po si Russia that next month, aside from the 1 million na commitment ni Saudi na bawas, on a daily basis, mayroon pong dagdag na 300,000 to 500,000 barrels per day din na idadagdag si Russia na production cut.
Time for some local corporate stories, starting with the local bourse. The Philippine Stock Exchange saw its net income climb by 11.6% in the first half of the year to 417.5 million pesos. In contrast, its operating revenue was nearly 13% lower year-on-year due to a decline in listing and trading-related fees. Meanwhile, PS Bank's net income grew 18% to 2.17 billion pesos in the first 6 months of 2023. This resulted in a higher return on equity of 11.4% compared to 10.4% last year. The thrift banking arm of the Metro Bank Group attributed the increase to an uptick in consumer loans, improvement in credit quality, and gains from productivity and efficiency initiatives. Meanwhile, its core revenue, composed of its net interest income from loans and investments, including fees, jumped by 8% year-on-year. And finally, Semirara Mining and Power reports a 10.2 billion peso net income for the second quarter. That's 5% lower than its record-setting 10.8 billion pesos in the same period last year. The Gunsuni-led miner cites weaker coal selling prices, total generation electricity sales, and average selling prices. The big drag came from what it called other income, which plunged by 63% as net forex gains dropped. For the first half of the year, net income dropped to 19.2 billion pesos, hurt also in part by high base effect. Apollo Global Capital says it is poised to begin extracting iron from the seafloor of southeastern Mindanao soon. This comes 3 years after the firm first said its lone mining vessel, the MV Siphon 1, was in position to commence the Philippines' first offshore iron mine. The firm now aims to begin normal operations within the current quarter, despite weather-related setbacks.
Conduct our operations normally, then conservatively, we're looking at around 30,000 metric tons of magnetite iron sand every month, which would probably be roughly around $3 million US dollars. I have to also give you the disclaimer that because the weather in Santa Ana area is quite unpredictable. Mm-hmm. We are seeing around 6 months of extraction. So in the meantime, we're also doing stockpiling.
Shakey's acquisition of Potato Corner bears fruit through several milestones. Potato Corner recently announced a partnership with nonprofit group Gawad Kalinga for the release of its so-called harvest chips. These chips are made from potatoes sourced locally from Benguet farmers under Gawad Kalinga's supervision. This new offering aims to help local farmers create a new income stream, which in turn is likewise in tune with Potato Corner's innovation play. Shakey's also touted Potato Corner's bid to grow guest and franchisee engagement through its National Fries Weekend held in July across the Philippines and in select stores abroad. The president and CEO of parent firm Pizza said the company remains committed to look for win-win opportunities for its stakeholders.